Hello and welcome to my review of LEGO's Crocodile Locomotive. This is a 1,271 piece kit that depicts an electric locomotive from Switzerland. It kind of looks like a GG1, and that's what caught my eye, but this is a very different kind of train. It was designed to haul coal on twisty, steep mountain routes. And as such, it only has a high speed of 40 miles per hour. And this kit came out in July of 2020. It is designed as one of the newer LEGO sets that are actually marketed to adults. You'll notice the age says 18 plus, although I'm sure if you had a kid that was very talented and detail-oriented, they could certainly handle putting this together. It's also designed as a static display model. However, it is also designed so you could add an electric motor and run it with any other LEGO train set. In fact, it also has the magnetic couplers on the front and back. There's also an optional LED lighting kit designed by a third-party company called BricsMax. Now, you'll want to decide before building this set whether you want to do the motor and the lights, although you can come back and add them later. I have decided for now not to do either one. I have no plans, or should I say, no room, to build an operating LEGO model train layout, so I'm not going to motorize mine. However, I may go back at some point and add the LED lighting kit, but for this build, I'm going to do it straight out of the box. I built this over Christmas weekend on 2021, and I spent a total of 7 to 8 hours split over the 2 days putting it all together. Now, LEGO does a good job, no matter how big or small the kit, of organizing things very well for you. You'll notice that this kit comes in 11 plastic bags. All but two are numbered for the major sub-assemblies. And this helps you keep things organized because this way you don't have to open everything at once. You can just open the bags that correspond to the sub-assembly you're working on and set the rest aside for later. The bag of parts that's not numbered is used throughout the various sub-assemblies, so you can open that one right away. And the final bag contains the instruction book, which has over 130 pages in it, and it contains the sticker with the stats on the locomotive to add to your display. Now, the first set of bags is only going to build the base and the track, and also the two engineer figures. And as with most LEGO kits, I can't help myself, but I put the minifigures together first. And this one gives you a male and a female engineer, and I was really happy to see the female engineer included in this set. So it's great to see something in here that acknowledges that us ladies like trains too. And last but not least, they include this orange brick separator piece. And trust me, if you build a kit this big with this many small parts, you're going to inevitably make some mistakes, and this tool makes it so much easier to separate the bricks, particularly the really tiny ones. And I'm not going to show a photograph of every step of building this, otherwise we'd be here all day. But the first tasks are to take the flat base plates and then to put the other flat pieces to form the rail bed and the ties. And then you flip it over and you put these black trim pieces, which give a nice, kind of frame for the display. Here's our engineers putting in the first rail, and very quickly the rails are completed. And these are compatible with the other LEGO railroad sets, should you want to run this instead of display it. And lastly, we end this step by putting on the plaque and the sticker. You'll also notice there's two 4-bump black bricks in the middle, and that's just to secure the locomotive down for display purposes so that it doesn't roll away. Next, I opened all of the number two bags, and this sub-assembly will build most of the center part of the unit for this locomotive. And on the real locomotive, that section would contain a lot of the electrical equipment and the control cabs. With the symmetrical design of this train, it has one cab facing in either direction, so you don't have to physically turn the locomotive around to change direction. The engineer just has to walk from one cab to another. And it starts with building this somewhat complicated intersection, which has all of the gearing. And what this does is it sets it up to be ready to receive the electric motor should you decide to add that. But all of it's eventually going to get buried and not seen in the final model. When it comes to assembling the wheels, The wheels that actually provide traction to the rails come with these red O-rings, and that's what gives it grip on the top of the rail, which is actually a gear-like tooth surface. But instead of having another gear, it's not a cog railway per se. They're just using these O-rings to give it grip. And then once all that's in place, you start building up the body around the gearing. And if you're going to put the motor in, this would be the time. And there is a separate section at the end of the book that deals with putting in the motor. I'm not going to cover that here. And once you have the base built, you start building the cab inside. The central section, you can tell it's depicting the insulators and electrical equipment. And then you have your control cab at either end. And that is not a steering wheel. That would most likely be a wheel that controls the brakes. And on the real locomotive, that would actually be mounted vertically, not horizontally. And I also like how it has these little hooks to clip the wrench and toolbox that the minifigures come with. A lot of Lego sets don't give you provisions, and those things tend to just get thrown in somewhere. So once you have that sub-assembly done, it just places inside of the lower portion of the body, which is nice because you can just remove it easily for doing work later on if needed. And then from there, you build up the side windows and walls. And that's as far as sub-assembly 2 goes. Now it'll take the bags for sub-assembly 3 to finish this center portion. And this was the quickest of the sub-assemblies to build. And quite frankly, it was the one I enjoyed the most because it was very technical. In this sub-assembly, you're building the electrical equipment atop the cabs. So primarily you're building the pantographs, which would get the electrical power from the catenary wires. And this was a combination of a lot of really tiny parts. And what's really cool is these pantographs go up and down like they would on the real locomotive. So I think Lego here did a really fantastic job detailing these. They look and operate very realistically. And this is an area where you really just want to go slow and take your time and get it right. I did have to redo a few things on mine, but the nice thing about building Legos is you can always take them back apart and fix them. So it looks like our engineers are getting pretty excited to drive their train, but we've still got to do the two ends. And both of those ends are built together from the bags for sub-assembly 4. There's a lot of parts for this, but it wasn't as difficult as building the center section. Now you can choose to either build one in its entirety and then go back and build the other. I decided to build them simultaneously because when you're building these big kits, quite frankly, you spend a lot of your time rooting around for parts. Even though I do try to organize them in bowls and such, it's still a lot of work to find the parts. And when you're hunting for the parts for each step, once you find the parts for one sub-assembly, you might as well keep going and find the other. And the first thing you build here are the wheeled sections, which on the real locomotive, I believe this is where the electric motor are that would actually propel the locomotive forward and backwards. And on the Lego model, you have one set of wheels that would actually do the driving, hence that they have the red O-rings around them. And even though this is an electrical locomotive, even the real world one has the driving rods that connect the sets of wheels that look more like an old steam locomotive. If you're a fan of the American GG1, you'll know that we don't have those on ours. And Lego hasn't replicated all of the driving rods on this locomotive, but it's enough to get an authentic look. And so the main section for each of these is built separate of the pilot wheels, and those are kept separate because this thing articulates as if it's actually 5 separate pieces. And that's what would help it both in the real world and on a Lego layout navigate the turns. I've seen photos and videos online of other people's builds, and this thing literally snakes through the curves as if it was a snake. It's pretty cool. So after building the engine modules and the pilot wheel modules, they all snap together pretty quickly. And the pilot wheels do contain the magnetic couplers so that if you wanted to hook this up to freight cars, you could pull them, or passenger cars. In the real world, it was actually used for both. It was primarily built for hauling coal, but it actually did see some use in passenger service. And then once that's done, all that's left is to build the body shelves that go above the wheels. And these each contain three lights on either end. And I always love when you put the lights on models because to me that's what brings it to life and kind of gives it a so-called face and personality. And so this part of the build actually goes very quickly. There's a lot of big pieces here, so you go from feeling like you're never going to finish to having it almost done pretty quickly. And then those two shells just snap on top of the wheel assemblies. And then there's just a simple hitch to attach each one to the central portion of the locomotive. And just like that, it's finished. And these engineers are ready to take it for a ride. Now, I don't know a whole lot about the real-life crocodile locomotive, but I have seen pictures, and when you see the real one, it looks less like three distinctive parts and more like one whole locomotive. And I have seen that there are people in the LEGO community who have made modifications to this to make those connecting points look a little bit more like the real thing. For all intents and purposes here, I just want this as a display piece on my shelf. Like I said, it reminds me of a GG1, which regulars to my channel know is my number one all-time favorite electric locomotive. And this is probably the closest thing that LEGO's ever going to make to a GG1, hence why I really wanted to buy it. So overall, I would say this is a wonderful building kit. It's something that adults or even teenagers could enjoy. And my advice would be if you buy this one or any of the other newer adult kits with thousands of pieces, just take your time with it, work methodically through the steps, and most importantly, have some fun with it. So I hope you've enjoyed this review. I certainly enjoyed building this locomotive, and if I decide to go back later and add the lighting kit, I'll do another video at that time. But for now, I just wanted to say thank you for watching.